Welcome to the fifth game. Choose one of the mannequins that you see before you and take the corresponding vest. The mannequins are numbered 1 through 16.
What should I do? The middle numbers are all taken. Only two choices left, front or back.
Pay attention, please. The vest number corresponds to the order in which you are playing.
The order that we're playing in? Okay, maybe the low numbers are better. It's better to get a head start. Wait, no. It would be far too dangerous to go first without knowing the game. 16? It's too dangerous to go last.
Look, Teddy. The fifth game has started.
Yeah, Zippy.
It looks dangerous and scary. I'm really excited to see the game.
Teddy, what data science techniques can you use to predict which players would win this game?
I don't know.
I guess we have to wait to find out what the game is first. Who are they? I think they are the VIPs, as in the rich sponsors of the Squid Game. Why do they have weird masks on? Look, they're announcing the game. Pay attention, Zippy.
Our fifth game is Glass Tempered Stones. The glass tiles in front of you are made from regular glass or tempered glass. Tempered glass can support the weight of two people. However, the regular glass breaks even if one person steps on it. You need to cross and reach the other side of the platform before the time ends. Those with smaller numbers on their vest will walk across first.
That means the number on us is the order in which we will cross the bridge. Thank goodness, I'm last.
Teddy, don't each player have their strengths and weaknesses?
Yes, and we can use Cox regression to predict how these characteristics affect the outcomes of the game.
Cox regression? Is that the same as the Kaplan-Meier time-to-event analysis we did in the episode 2 of the Honeycomb Challenge? In survival analysis, we can use parametric or non-parametric techniques for modeling the survival function. The Kaplan-Meier is a non-parametric estimator, meaning that it does not rely on any assumptions and the data does not have to follow a specific distribution. Does this mean that Cox regression is a parametric test? Actually, Cox regression or proportional hazards model is a semi-parametric test. It is not fully parametric because even if the regression parameters are known, the distribution of the outcome remains unknown. Oh, I see. This means that Cox regression has a lot of flexibility and allows us to model the impact of each player characteristic on survival. That's right, Sippy. These characteristics are called covariates. Here's the glass tile dataset. We have information on age, sex, stability, which is like balance, amount of calories in the last meal, and so on. Looks interesting. We also have the glass assessment ability variable. Yes, Teddy, this indicates the ability of a player to determine whether a piece of glass is made from regular or tempered glass. So, players who work in the glass industry have an added advantage here. Cool. To start, why don't you install RStudio, Zippy? Copy that. Installing. Installing. Done.
To run Cox regression, we need three packages: Survival, SurfMiner, and GT Summary.
Got it. Loading. Loading. And done.
Let's fit a Cox model using the surf function to create the object and the Cox pH function to fit the model.
Okay,
done! Wow, the results look a little messy. That's right, CP. Let's clean the results using the TBL regression function in the GT summary package.
Okay,
done!
Ah, this looks much better now. So, based on these results, it looks like being a guy is associated with having a greater risk or hazard of dying.
That's correct, Zippy. On the other hand, having a higher glass assessment score is inversely associated with death.
This means that players who are able to distinguish between regular glass and tempered glass have better chances of surviving. That makes complete sense, Teddy. Wow! We can also plot the output as a forest graph using the GG forest function. Okay, plotting, and done! It's so easy, isn't it, Zippy? Now, we can see all the results in a graph form. That's right, Teddy Bear. Come, let's watch the glass tile game.
Let the game begin. Each player take off your shoes and go up to the tiles.
There are 10 tiles left and 11 people still in the game. The three of us will get across to the end.
That might not be true. If someone gets scared and starts to wait out the time, we're in danger at the back of the line.
It's the left tile. It's the left one. Get it together.
Thanks a lot.
Doing good. Just keep going.
Move quick. You can't just stop there.
Hold on. Give me 1 second. I can tell these glass panels apart.
You can?
I made glass for 3 decades. Tempered glass. When lit from the side, has faint stain marks.
Hey, they turned off the lights.
I can't see. It's too dark.
Let me peek.
What's going on? The VIP has collapsed.
From the day we arrived on the planet, and blinking step into the sun, there's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done.
Is he alive?
Teddy, is that you? Teddy?